Welcome to God's Word on Air with Nelie Guterai. We are so glad you could join us. Every message is designed to build your faith, line upon line and precept upon precept. And now, today's message. Be blessed. Welcome to God's Word on Air with Nelie Guterai. We are so glad you could join us. Every message is designed to build your faith, line upon line and precept upon precept. And now, today's message. Be blessed.
Hello everyone. This is God's Word on Air with Nelie Guterai. You are welcome to another great time as we share God's Word together. Happy New Year once again. The year is still brand new. I welcome you to this awesome year 2022, the year of supernatural speed as the Lord spoke to me. Praise the Lord. It's a year where God has destined you to run, overtake, accomplish great things, finish well and strong speedily. Praise the Lord. And so before I continue, I just want us to have a short prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we just want to say thank you for this opportunity you have given us, Father, to just break your bread, the bread of life together. Lord, I pray for as many that are listening from all over the world, that this year 2022, you will do great things in their lives in the name of Jesus. I pray that as they listen this morning, that you will release a word in their lives that will set them on their feet and cause them to run speedily and accomplish great things in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Praise the Lord. So I want to talk on what I call the ephod experience. The ephod experience, aka garment of prayer or garment of communication with God, or the cloak of righteousness that gives you access to the divine. Praise the Lord. And I'm going to take my text from 1 Samuel 30, 7 to 8. Quickly I read 1 Samuel 30, 7 to 8. Bible says, "And David said to Abiathar the priest, Ahimelech's son, I pray thee, bring me hither the ephod. And Abiathar brought hither the ephod to David. And David inquired at the Lord, saying, Shall I pursue after this troop? Shall I overtake them? And he answered him, Pursue, for thou shalt surely overtake them, and without fail recover all. Praise the Lord. And I pray for you, whatever you have lost in 2021 or even beyond that, I pray that you shall overtake, pursue, overtake, and recover all in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. This is a very interesting story. Most of us, I'm sure we've heard of this Bible passage before. And if we take it from verse chapter 29, it's actually a very season of discouragement for David. David had, because he was still running from Saul, and so out of desperation, he had gone to join himself with the Philistines. Of course, we know that these were enemies of Israel. But out of desperation, he had joined himself with a man called, Achish. And he had fought side by side with him, and he had been loyal. If you look at David's life, one thing remarkable about him was that he was a very loyal person. And so he had been faithful and he had been loyal. But in this particular battle in 1 Samuel 29, he was actually, rejected. The Philistine lords were not comfortable with him because they were going to fight Israel. And so they were afraid that because of that good trait he has, that trait of loyalty and faithfulness, he might turn against them, in the battle and actually, fight, stand with Israel. And so they told Achish, this man cannot fight with us. And so Achish was trying to make a case for him. This man has been loyal to me, he has been faithful all these years, and I've not had any reason to doubt him, but they refused. And so Achish had to, send David away. Praise the Lord. And so David was in that place of, it was a low point in his life. He was actually discouraged. He was worn out and all that. But in this place, he came back home, at least came back to Ziklag, where he had left his family and the families of his men, only to meet another blow. The city had been sacked. He his wives were nowhere to be found. His children were all gone, and also the wives and children of his soldiers, they were all gone. And so even the people thought of stoning him, because they were like, we stood by you, we've been fighting with you, trying to get your throne back, and this is what we get. This is how we are being repaid. You allowed us to follow you in this, you know, this costless battle, and only to leave our families unguarded. And David was at that point. He had a choice. He could have as well just, you know, been discouraged and given up. But he didn't do that. And he told the priest, give me the ephod. What was he saying? Allow me. I need to commune with God. I need to pray. I need to see God's face. I had made a mistake. Excuse me. I had made a mistake by going to join myself with the enemy. I didn't even ask God. And look at what has happened. But this time around, I want to do it right. Praise the Lord. And when he did it right, God released the word immediately. He said, David, go ahead, pursue, for you shall surely overtake them. And without fail, you will recover all. Praise the Lord. And if you read the rest of the story, that's what happened. Hallelujah. And so what exactly is an ephod? I'm sure somebody is asking that. You know, the olden days ephod, or the ephod we know before now, is a linen apron worn in ancient Hebrew rites. It's a sacred clothing worn by the high priest at the command of God. And it is usually worn during holy ceremonies. We see that in Exodus 28, 6 to 8, and also Exodus 39, 2 to 5, where God gave Moses specifications on how this garment was to be designed to invoke his divine presence. Praise the Lord. And so when David asked for this ephod, he was also trying to invoke God's presence, and he got it, because the Bible tells us in Psalm 34, 5, 15, 16, and 17, he said, the eyes of the Lord are upon the righteous, and his ears are open unto their cry. The face of the Lord is against them that do evil, to cut off the remembrance of them from the earth. He said, but the righteous cry, verse 17, and the Lord heareth and delivereth them out of all their troubles. The cry is not just physically crying, but when we pray, God will hear and God will deliver. Just the same way he delivered David out of all his troubles. If you look at the life of David, all his life was in a battle. But a time came when that which he was fighting for got to his hands. He finally became the king of Israel. Praise the Lord. And so it doesn't matter what you are experiencing or what you've experienced before now. Like I said, David had a choice, either to trust what he was experiencing physically, or that is his tired, discouraged, and rejected self, or to trust God and God's promises over his life. And he chose to trust God. Praise the Lord. He did not wait for any man. He did not start going around looking for who to pray for, in prayer warriors, intercessors, pastors, prophets. No, he asked for the ephod himself. So I want to encourage you in this year 2022, if you want to prevail, if you want to run with speed, if you want to accomplish those great things that God has indeed spoken concerning you and concerning your generation and your family, this is the season of prayer. Don't relent. It is not the time for you to say, no, God has already spoken it. So it's all done. No, it is a time for you to stay in a place of prayer until there's a physical manifestation. David did not wait. When God said pursue, when he prayed and God said pursue, overtake, you recover all. He did not just say, okay, and God has said it, let me. No, he went ahead to pursue. He went ahead to overtake, and he went ahead to recover all. And the truth of the matter is, when you stay in the place of prayer, God will give you instructions. Hallelujah. And your help might come from unlikely sources. You know, I find it very interesting. When David got that word, it was in verse 11 that we're told, in the process of trying to look for his family and the families of his men, they came upon an Egyptian. Verse 11 says, and they found an Egyptian in the field and brought him to David and gave him bread, and he did eat, and they made him drink water. And they gave him a piece of cake, a cake of figs, and two clusters of raisins. And when he had eaten, his spirit came again to him, for he had eaten no bread nor drunk any water 3 days and 3 nights. And David said unto him, to whom belongest thou, and where art thou from? And he said, I am a young man of Egypt, a servant to an Amalekite, and my master left me because 3 days ago I fell sick. we made an invasion upon the south of the Cherethites, and upon the coast which belonged to Judah, and came upon the south of Caleb, and we burned Ziklag with fire. Praise the Lord. That was what David wanted to hear. At least he has gotten direction. And so it was this same man that they saw abandoned by the side of the road that actually helped them to recover home, because he pointed them to the right direction and he begged for his life. Please, by the time you come upon my masters and you recover, or don't leave me in their hands because they will kill me. Praise the Lord. And so this is a season where we need to be sensitive to God's direction, because he's going to give it. It's a season where we will not leave anything to chance, because even that, just imagine if they had abandoned him, if they had just seen him as a weak man, the diamond on the side of the road, and they left him and walked away. That was the answer to their prayer. Praise the Lord. So this season, I beg you, be sensitive to God. Hallelujah. And don't leave your mountain of prayer, just like Elijah did. When we read 1 Kings 17, we see Elijah, the prediction of the drought. And so in 1 Kings 18, he also reversed that drought. Told Ahab, it is the time, there's an sound of abundance of rain. But the truth is that when he told Ahab, go and eat and drink, he himself, the prophet, did not go and eat and drink. The Bible tells us it's 1 Kings 18:42. So Ahab went up to eat and to drink, and Elijah went up to the top of Carmel, and he cast himself down upon the earth and put his face between his knees. And it came to pass at the seventh time that he said, behold, there ariseth a little cloud out of the sea, like a man's hand. And he said, go up, say unto Ahab, prepare thy chariot and get thee down, that the rain stop thee not. Praise the Lord. When he put his face between his knees, it was a position of prayer. He also put on the ephod, a garment of prayer. And he prayed until he saw his prophecy come to pass. So in this year 2022, no matter what God has told you concerning your 2022, it is a season of prayer. Pray it into manifestation. And when you do that, it will come to pass. Praise the Lord. Right now, we don't need a physical effort. We don't need any special garment to put on before we can pray. Jesus is our spiritual garment. Hallelujah. Because the Bible tells us in John 14:6, it said, Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. So Jesus is our spiritual garment. Put on the cloak of Jesus. Put on the righteousness of Jesus and pray your way through. Praise the Lord. Because of Jesus, we have access to the throne room, according to Hebrews 4:14-16. Let me just quickly read it. Hebrews 4:14-16. Okay, I think I'm going to take it from, he said, for 15 says, for we have not an high priest, that is Jesus, which cannot be touched with the feeling of our infirmities, but was in all points tempted like as we are, yet without sin. 14, Hebrews 4:16 now says, let us therefore come boldly unto the throne room of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace in to help in time of need. Praise the Lord. So in this year 2022, put on your spiritual effort throughout this year if you want to experience speed for supernatural divine accomplishment. And as you do that, God will indeed give you speed that to accomplish everything that he has spoken concerning you and concerning your family and concerning your nation in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. But before I go, I always say it. If you are not in the sheepfold, you are doing yourself a disservice. So if you are outside of the sheepfold, I quickly want to pray for you. That means those that have not given their lives to Christ. Because for you to partake of every good thing that God has for us in this year 2022, you have to be one of his child. Praise the Lord. And so what I'm saying is meant for those that are children, not strangers. So I want you to be one of the child or children of, or one of the child of God. And so I'm inviting you to this short prayer. I want you to just quickly say with me, and you mean it in your heart, Lord Jesus, have mercy upon me. Forgive me my sin. Right, wash me clean by your blood. In any way I've sinned against you, Lord, have mercy upon me. Write my name in the book of life and count me among your sheep in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. If you have said those prayers, I want to quickly tell you and joyfully tell you that there's rejoicing in heaven, because for just one soul that has given their life to Christ, there's celebration in heaven. And I also encourage you to look for a Bible-believing church where you go there and tell them you've just given your life to Christ on this program, and you take it up from there. God bless you, and I want to pray with you. Father, in the name of Jesus, for as many that have heard your word of life this morning and have given their lives to you, Father, Lord, I ask, oh Lord, that your mercy will speak for them in the name of Jesus. Lord, establish them in your love and in your grace in the name of Jesus. Lord, lead them, Holy Spirit, lead them to that place where they will flourish and be nourished in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen. And so, I want to say congratulations again. And so before I go quickly, I just want to pray generally for everybody, for every one of us that have entered 2022. Like I said, it's still a new year. I pray that the grace of God will meet you and the grace for you to put on your effort, the garment of your effort, and to pray your way into victory be released unto you this morning in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for in Jesus' mighty name we pray. God bless you until we meet again. Keep trusting and keep believing that Jesus is Lord.
Thank you for listening to today's message. For more information, prayer requests, or to share your testimonies, send us an email at godswordonair@gmail.com and follow us on Facebook, Instagram, subscribe to our YouTube channel, or listen to us on MixLR, all at God's Word on Air with Nelly Eguterai. Till we meet again, same time next week, keep building your faith on God's Word.